Welcome back to Pentagram Prime, everyone. In case you hadn't guessed, this is the new aesthetic. Hope you like my brand of red and black ink. So today we will be evaluating exercise one in Marsden and Hoffman on page 301, where we are asked to find out the value of the integral of 1 over x squared minus 2 plus 4. Evaluated from negative infinity to positive infinity. And this little part over here I actually put in mostly for the people who are looking at my content on Tumblr, so don't worry too much about it. We will be evaluating this integral using residue theorem, and the first thing we're going to do is define f of z as 1 over z squared minus 2z plus 4, and then we need to go ahead and find the zeros in the denominator. Using quadratic formula with the values of positive 1, negative 2, and positive 4 for a, b, and c respectively gives us the ultimate value of 1 plus or minus I root 3 for the zeros of the denominator of f of z. If we turn to page 296 and examine table 431, specifically part 2, we find that the ratio of two polynomials, p and q, taken across the entire real axes is equal to 2 pi I times the sum of the residues of P over Q in the upper half of the complex plane. P and Q, of course, need to be polynomials. The degree of Q must be greater than or equal to 2 plus the degree of P, and there are no zeros allowed of Q on the real axes. For our purposes, P over Q will be equal to F of Z. And if we break down the polynomial in the denominator, we find that p over q is equal to 1 over z minus 1 plus I root 3 times z minus 1 minus I root 3. The techniques used in part 2 of table 431 derive from a path integral along the real axes that is closed up by a semicircle of infinite radius r. There are only two points in the complex plane that form singularities, and it's the one in the upper half equal to 1 plus I root 3 that we will be using to solve the definite integral. Having established that there is only one singularity to deal with, the figure of 2 pi I times the sum of the residues in the upper half plane, which I kind of messed up here because I did not put the z naught on the end, so sorry about that. That summation becomes 2 pi I times the residue of f of z, expressed here, evaluated at 1 plus I root 3. If you take a moment and turn to page 244, you will find proposition 412. This allows us to evaluate a residue for a simple pole at z naught, and what will happen is, for a given function f of z, we're going to break it up into g of z divided by h of z, and the result will be, when evaluated at z naught, for the residue will be g of z naught divided by h prime of z naught. The requirements for using this formula are that g of z naught must be non-zero, h of z naught must equal zero, and h prime of z naught must be non-zero. Now we're using the same f of z that we used before, and for our purposes, g of z will be equal to 1 for all z. H of z will be equal to z minus 1 plus I root 3 times z minus 1 minus I root 3. And this, of course, this formula here is also equal to z squared minus 2z plus 4. So for evaluating h prime of z, we will be taking the derivative of z squared minus 2z plus 4. And the result, using good old high school calculus, is 2z minus 2. G of z naught, evaluated at z naught equal to 1 plus I root 3, is going to be equal to 1, of course, because g of z has already been shown to be equal to 1 everywhere. So that satisfies the requirements for g. H of z naught, when evaluated at 1 plus I root 3, is going to give us a value of 0 because it cancels out the first term. And that satisfies our requirements for h of z naught. Evaluating h prime of z naught, which unfortunately got interrupted by me getting used to the new pens I've been using, so sorry about the smudged ink. evaluates as 2 times 1 plus I root 3 minus root 2. And it might be obvious here, this 1 and this 2 kind of cancel out because the 1's multiplied times 2. End result is 2i root 3, and that is non-zero, which satisfies our requirements for h prime of z naught, which means we are clear to use proposition 412 to evaluate the residue that we need. So having established our formula for the residue of f of z at 1 plus I root 3, we insert g of z naught over h prime of z naught of course being 1 plus I root 3. This gives us 1 in the numerator and 2i root 3 in the denominator, quantity multiplied times 2 pi I. 2's drop out, the i's drop out, and the result is pi over root 3. Therefore, the integral of 1 over x squared minus 2x plus 4 evaluated from negative infinity to positive infinity is equal to pi over root 3, and it's all cake and ice cream from here. Till next time, this is Pentagram Prime signing off.